Hello everyone, welcome back. My name is Rajni Chaudhary and we are studying transformer protection. As discussed, the transformer protection video was divided into three parts: part 1, part 2 and part 3. The part 1 has already been completed and the link is provided in the description box. For those who haven't watched, I recommend them they should watch part 1 before starting the part 2. As in part 1, we have covered the brief description about transformer and the types of fault that occur in transformer. Starting with the part 2, here we will be covering the transformer differential protection technique. The contents of the part 2 will include transformer differential protection, the basic considerations or the rules applied for CT connections in case of differential protection. Then we will be studying the differential protection technique applied to star-star unit transformer and star-delta unit transformer. Transformer differential protection. Differential protection is also known as the Mears-Price scheme, or you must have heard the name bias differential protection or percentage bias differential protection in various books. We have studied this type of protection in generator and in induction motor too. But in case of transformer, there are some considerations for CT which need to be taken care of before applying the differential protection. So this becomes an important topic for transformer protection. Transformer differential protection or the Mears-Price scheme. These are employed for transformers of large ratings. As the name suggests, differential protection, it responds to vector difference between the two similar actuating quantities. The two CTs are connected at each end of the transformer winding. Pilot wires are connected between the CTs. Biased coils are also present in series with the pilot wires to avoid unwanted operation. When an internal fault occurs, the current are not equal and the difference current flows to the operating coil of the relay. This current will provide the operating torque, whereas the current flowing in the restraining coil will provide the restraining torque. The relay will operate in case when operating torque is greater than the restraining torque. Basic considerations that need to be taken care of while applying differential protection in case of transformers. The first one is transformation ratio. We know that transformer is used for increasing or decreasing voltage or current level, and therefore the primary and secondary side current are not same, as they vary in inverse ratio to their corresponding voltages, as you can see in this equation. Therefore, to compensate this, we need to apply different transformation ratio for the CT. Means the CT ratios applied on both sides of the transformer must be different. These ratios depend upon the line current of power transformer and the connections of the CT, whether in star or whether in delta. When such transformation ratio is adopted, second consideration, current transformer connections. Taking transformer connections in star delta, that is, the primary winding is connected in star and secondary winding is connected in delta. In this case, we will be seeing that the secondary current will have a phase shift of 30 degree relative to the primary current. And thus, this phase shift need to be taken care of, otherwise the CTs connected at the both sides of the transformer will respond in a different manner. Thus, the CTs on delta side are connected in star. To compensate that 30 degree phase shift. Also, the zero sequence current flow on the star side of the transformer. And whereas we don't see any zero sequence current flowing into the delta side. Therefore, the zero sequence current must be eliminated from the star side by connecting its CT in delta. Therefore, with this arrangement of transformer connections having star and delta, the CT connections will be delta star. With such an arrangement, the phase displacement between the currents get compensated with the oppositely connected CT secondary. And thus, the current that will be fed to your pilot wire will be having both sides in the same phase and during normal running conditions. And in this case, the relay will not operate. This need to be taken care of. Please note that the primary connections of power transformer and CT are just opposite. If it is star, it will be delta. If it is delta, it will be star. In the same way, if the secondary connections of power transformer are in delta, the secondary connection of CT will be in star. And if the power transformer secondary connection are in star, the CT secondary connection will be in delta. Opposite connections are preferred to replace to cope up with the phase displacement. Third consideration, bias to cover tap changing facility. We know that some of the transformers have tap changing arrangement so that voltage control can take place. In this, the turn ratio of the CT on both sides of power transformers are also provided with the tap to get adjusted with the tap setting arrangement of the transformers. Fourth consideration, magnetization inrush. When a transformer is given the supply, a magnetizing inrush current flows into the primary winding whose equivalent is not present into the secondary winding. As this magnetization inrush current is used to magnetize the iron core, the net effect of this will be considered as an internal fault by the differential protection. Thus, a unit must be added with the differential protection who can distinguish between the magnetizing current and the fault current. Generally, a harmonic restraint unit or supervisory unit is used with differential unit to cope up with this magnetizing inrush current. The picture depicts the differential protection techniques applied to the star-star power transformer. Star-star power transformer depicts that the primary winding of the transformer is connected in star, you can see here. In the same way, the secondary side of the power transformer is also connected in the star. A neutral can be found on both sides. To cope up with the zero sequence current produced in the star side, the CT connections applied at the both sides of the transformer must be connected in delta. And you can see in the figure that the primary side of the transformer is provided with delta connected CTs, and in the same way, the secondary side of the power transformer is also provided with delta connected CT secondaries. These are the CT secondary currents are then fed to the restraining coil, whose midpoint is then provided to the operating coil. OC here represent the operating coil and RC represent the restraining coil, whereas the CB represent the circuit breakers. Whenever the torque produced in the operating coil will be greater than the restraining coil torque, the relay will operate in this case. The operating coils are connected in the midpoint of the restraining coils. These are the pilot wires. The picture here depicts the differential protection technique applied to the star-delta power transformers. Star-delta power transformer means that the primary side of the transformer is connected in star, as you can see a neutral point here, whereas the secondary side of the power transformer is connected into delta. To cope up with the phase shift so produced, the delta side power transformer must be connected into star connected CT, and the zero sequence so produced need to be compensated with the help of the delta connected CT secondary. These are then connected to the restraining and the operating coil. Pallet wires are used in series with the restraining coils. The restraining coil and the operating coil combinations make your differential relay. These are the pallet wires. Thus, the transformer differential protection is quite typical as compared to the differential protection technique applied in case of generator and induction motor, as several considerations need to be taken care of in this. Listed are some of the references from where the content has been taken. For the concluding remarks of transformer protection part 2, here we have discussed the transformer differential protection. This protection technique is also applied in case of generators and induction motors for providing protection against face-to-face and face-to-ground faults. Although some basic considerations need to be taken care while applying differential protection in case of transformers, like CT connections need to be taken care of. Also, what type of transformers are applied. With this, we end the lecture. Part 2 of transformer protection is completed here. For part 3, please stay connected and subscribe the channel.